TV centre had been inundated all day here at Shepherd's Bush because you've got two great bands playing against one another. They are Spandau and Duran Duran. Firstly, let's meet Nick Rhodes. Roger Taylor. Simon Le Bon. Andy Taylor. And the skipper, John Taylor. That's the Duran side there facing the might of Spandau Ballet here. John Steve Norman. Martin Kemp. Gary Kemp. And their spokesperson, Tony Hadley. Right, round one is an intros round. We're going to go to Nick first. All the intros actually come from this year. Okay, Nick, here's yours. And it was, for 2 points?
The Eurythmics, Here Comes the Rain Again.
Here Comes the Rain, Eurythmics. All right, John Keeble, an intro for you.
What is love?
Yep.
Howard Jones.
Howard Jones, what is it? Hey! Right, Simon, intro for you. And it was.
That was David Bowie in Modern Love.
David Bowie in Modern Love. Martin, let's see how to do with your intro.
David Essex, with the
song. Feels like heaven from fiction. So, nothing there. John, this is your intro.
Rolling Stones on the cover of the night.
2 points. Things really hotting up now. Tony, some intro for you. And it was?
Queen Radio Gaga.
Queen Radio Gaga! Another intro, Andy, this one's yours.
Cindy Lauper, Girls Wanna Have Fun.
Girls Wanna Have Fun. All from this year. Gary, your intro coming up.
Madness?
What was the song?
My Girl's Mad at Me, and it's Tracy Ullman!
Tracy Ullman! Oh, dear! Oh, 2 points, and on we go. Roger, one for you. You're looking glum.
I haven't got a clue.
It's Matthew Wilder, and Break My Stride. Finally, in this round, Steve Norman, your turn. Okay. It's coming, it's coming.
Oh, it's there, it's there. No, I can't think. No idea.
Carmel. Oh, sorry. More. You see, a skipper, if he'd been a cheating type of person, would have told you, but he wasn't, which is good. So at the end of round one, we have Spandau with 6 points and Duran Duran with 8 points. Round two for both teams, a winter compilation. We've edited together 10 songs about winter weather or winterish weather. Right, and you need the artists. All the songs are about winter weather, and here they come. Emptiness and just a memory. Face to face with a ragged truth, mixed up a tawny tale.
Windows and empty hallway.
Okay, 10 songs, winter compilation. John, how many do you think you've got before we come out?
Well, think being the opposite word, 9.
You think you have 9. Tony, how many do you think you have?
We've got 9.
9. Okay, yes. John, do you want to fire yours off first? I'll tell you afterwards how you did.
Okay, the first one we don't know. The second one is a very rough guess at Meatloaf. Number 3, Ann Peebles. 4, UB40. 5, David Essex. 6, Supertramp. 7, Good Old Shaky. Kinks, number 8. Lena Lovitch, number 9. Foreigner, 10.
Okay, tell me how you did in a moment. Tony?
Right, number 1 we couldn't actually think of.
Right.
Number 2 was The Alarm. Mm-hmm. Number 3, Eruption. Number 4, UB40. Number 5, David Essex. Number 6, Supertramp. Number 7, Shaky Stevens. Number 8, The Kinks. Number 9 we thought was Nina Hagen, and number 10 was Foreigner.
Okay, it was Donna Summer with Winter Melody. Alarm, Where Were You Hiding When the Storm Broke? Eruptions, I Can't Stand the Rain, the original of which was Ann Peebles. UB40, I Think It's Going to Rain Today. Cool Out Tonight, David Essex. Raining Again from Supertramp. It's Raining from Shaky. Autumn Almanac, The Kinks. Yoko Ono's Walking on Thin Ice. And Foreigner's Cold as Ice. So Duran got 6 and Spandau 8. As we head into round 3, Duran Duran 14, Spandau Ballet 14. Right, onto the lyric round next. John and Martin together, here's yours, right? Stalked in the forest, too close to hide, I'll be upon you by the moonlight side. Do you recognize who that's by? I'm going to have to tell you, it's this one.
But I got the next line.
Yes.
I didn't get the title.
I'll tell you what. If you can sing the next line, I'll give you a bonus point.
He's thinking. Go on, guy.
Skin is so white.
Call that singing.
What is the point for that?
No.
Nothing for that one. Nick and Simon, for you, here's yours. Standing in the dark, I was waiting for the man to come.
Oh, I'm sure he's still.
To cut
short.
A long story short. Very good. Tony, 2 lines for you. With a step to your left and a flick to the right, you catch that mirror way out west.
Oh dear.
With a step to your left,
Rio.
And a flick to the right, it was Rio. The next line for a bonus point.
And you look like you're the best, or
and
something.
You look like you're the best.
That's our bonus point for that, yeah.
No, it's not.
No,
actually.
It's not.
We're taking the point back.
The step to your left and the flick to the right. Catch a mirror's way out west. You know you're something special.
Take the point away. John, your lyric coming up. Why do I find it hard to write the next line when I want the truth to be said?
True.
And the next line is easy.
I know this much is true.
Bonus point. Right, Gary and Steve, here's yours. And fiery demons all dance when you walk through that door.
Is it Union of the Snake?
It's not.
I don't know why they're cheering, because it's not. It's this one.
And fiery demons all dance when you walk through that door.
Is there something I should know? Right, finally, this round. Andy and Roger, for you, surprisingly, a Spandau lyric. She used to be a diplomat, but now she's down the laundromat. She used to be a diplomat, but now she's down the laundromat.
It's the other one. It's true. It's highly strung.
She's highly strung.
Highly strung, yes.
I've seen on National Times this morning.
So, at the end of round three, we have Spandau Ballet with 16, Duran Duran with 20. Round four is the spot the star round, all right? Captains only, fingers on the buzzers. As soon as you know who the star is, and this guy is doing his former occupation, underneath is a piece of music backwards, not related to the star, but related to his occupation. As soon as you've identified the backwards music and the star concerned doing his former occupation, fingers on the buzzers, and I'll ask you in a second who it is. Well, Duran's light actually came on first, so who do you think it was?
I think it's Norwegian wood, but it's Fish from Marillion.
Well guessed, yes, Fish from Marillion, and the Beatles' Norwegian wood. So the 4 points go to Duran. So at the end of round four, we have Spandau Ballet with 16, Duran Duran with 25. But anything could happen. In round five, a lot of concentration coming up because we actually want 12 answers. You can confer each team. Three videos coming up, all with a wrong soundtrack. I want to know who the video is, artist and title, and who the soundtrack is, artist and title in each case.
Strange lady, she made me nervous. She took me in and gave me breakfast. 5-4-3-2-1.
Right, that was the first one for Duran. They've been frantically scribbling there. Okay. Have you got any answers?
Yeah. First one was Thompson Twins, Into the Gap, and the song playing was Huey Lewis.
What was the Thompson Twins track?
Into the Gap.
Go on.
No.
Okay. What was his guess?
Second one was Elton John, The Passenger, I think, and the backing track was Men at Work.
Down Under.
Which is Down Under.
Right.
Third one was Madness, Our House. And it was 5-4-3-2-1 by Manfred Mann.
Right, I can give you 5 out of 6 because you dropped on one place and it was You Take Me Up, the Thompson Twins. 5 out of 6 is good going. Over to Spandau, same applies to you. 3 clips and 12 answers altogether.
Right, can I name the first 3 videos first?
Okay.
Yeah, okay. The first one was Herbie Hancock with Rocket. Second one was Culture Club with War, the War sure. song. Third one was Yazoo with Don't Go.
Right.
On the track side of things, has anyone got the first one?
We missed the first one.
We missed the first one. Blinding Me with Science, Thomas Dolby was the second one. And War, Edwin Starr was the third.
Right, yes, you've dropped one as well, so you get 5 out of 6, too. Let It All Blow, the Daz Band was the video on the first one. So 5 out of 6 for Spandau, 5 out of 6 for Duran. Makes the score, the end of round 5. 21 to Spandau Ballet, 30 to Duran Duran. Round 6, an individual round. We kick off with Nick Rhodes. For you, a clip of David Byrne and Talking Heads. Okay, in November 1980, Talking Heads released an album which featured Robert Palmer and Nona Hendrix, in which their very first single came. Can you name the album?
In what year?
1980, November.
That wasn't their first album.
No, it wasn't. Their first hit came from the album.
Oh, the album is called Remain in Light.
Remain in Light, yes, well done. 2 points. Right, John Keeble, for you, some Dire Straits from last year. Right, for 2 points, can you name the Dire Straits album which came out this year, live?
Alchemy.
Alchemy is right for 2 points. And John Taylor, a clip for you from 1976 of Genesis performing Ripples from Trick of the Tail. Two points. Can you name the members of the band at that time, 1976?
Phil Collins, Steve Hackett, Mike Rutherford, Tony Banks.
Absolutely right. 4 out of 4.
Congratulations.
2 points there. Martin, for you, here's Jimmy Page and Robert Plant in the middle of Zeppelin's Stairway to Heaven. Clip there from A Song Remains the Same, which has just come out on video. No points for that. The points, if you can tell me, the link between Zeppelin and Phil Lynott. The link between Zeppelin and Phil Lynott.
They both wrote Total Pop's theme music.
They did indeed, absolutely spot on. Nobody spotted any cheating at all during that particular bit. Right, Simon next for you, some Grace Jones in her disco days impersonating a tiger here on Do or Die. Right, her first top 10 UK hit was what?
Written by Chrissie Hynde, song called Private Lives.
Yes, it was Private Life, and the other question was who originally did it?
Chrissie Hynde, Pretenders.
Pretenders, absolutely right, 2 points. Real needle match, this one. Tony, for you, some vintage Freddie Mercury and Queen from Christmas 1974 doing a 100-mile-an-hour version of Jailhouse Rock. Queen have had four top 20 hits this year from their current album Works. Can you name them?
Oh, God. I Want to Break Free. God. That's right, hold it. Let me write his there. Want to Break Free. Radio Gaga.
Yeah, two.
Hammer to Fall.
Three. For the 2 points, I need the last one as well.
Hold it. All right, for him, it's all right,
it's not easy.
Hard Life.
It's a Hard Life.
Mumble, mumble.
2 points there. And Andy, for you, a clip of the Kinks. we got for you, Andy, a clip of the Kinks of Christmas actually singing Waterloo Sunset. Right, that was the top 10 record for the Kinks back in 1967. Their first two records allegedly sold about 127 copies between them, and the third one came out and was a number one, big number one, in 1964. Their first hit.
The only one that knows, you really got me.
It's a good job you guessed that one, because that's the answer.
Yeah!
Right, 2 points there. Gary, for you, some Bruce Springsteen doing Thunder Road.
Now I got this guitar, and I learned how to make her talk. My car's out back, if you're ready to take that long walk. From your front porch to my front seat, the door's open.
The only man to use the clockwork drummer on session. Sometimes it'll wind up things. Right over to you, Gary, who claims he's never heard of Bruce Springsteen, Eden. Thunder Road there from the Born to Run album. What was the follow-up album, which came out 2.5 years later?
Nebraska? The River?
Neither. Darkness on the Edge of Town. So, Darkness at the Edge of Town there. No points there. Roger Taylor, for you, a clip of The Clash playing Bank Robber.
Daddy was a bank robber, but he never hurt nobody. He just loved to live that way, and he loved to take out money. I love. No man's broke up in
was Clash. You've never actually made the top 10. They've only made the top 20 four times, despite the number of hits they've had. Can you name the other three records that got into the top 40 for you, top 20 for them, sir?
Rock the Casbah.
Sir?
Rock the Casbah.
No, surprisingly, it didn't make the 20.
London Calling.
London Calling was one.
Should I Stay or Should I Go?
Was another one. And for the full 2 points, the third one.
Complete Control.
No, I'll give you one out of two. It was Tommy Gunn. One out of two. Finally in this round, a rather sweet Billy Idol in Generation X. And King Rocker for Steve Norman.
Jailhouse Rocker, who's straight out of Memphis.
Right, we've all decided. We've all decided it doesn't look like Kim Wilde on there. Since leaving Generation X, Billy Idol's put out two albums which have been hits in the USA and smaller hits here. Can you name them?
Billy Idol was the first one.
And that sounded like the second one. Rebel Yell, absolutely, yes. Two points there, and at the end of that round, we have Spandau Ballet with 29, Duran Duran with 39. Right, into the quickfire round, fingers on the buzzers, right, and the lights to come up, I will take first. 2 points for each answer, 1 point if you get it wrong, I throw it over to somebody else. The first number one of 1984 was a cover version. What was it? Yes, Tony Hadley.
Only You by the Flying Pickets.
2 points. In 1984, Meatloaf had a hit with Modern Girl. Who had a hit with the same title in 1984? John and Martin. Throw it over to somebody else. In 1980, John.
Sheena Easton
for One Day. Which opera did Malcolm McLaren pillage this year? Nick and Simon.
Madame Butterfly.
Madame Butterfly, 2 points. ZZ Top had a hit album called Eliminator. How many of the group have beards? Yes, John and Martin.
Two. And the drummer is called Frank Beard.
Absolutely right.
Bonus point.
Right, earlier this year, Neil Kinnock appeared in a Tracy Ullman video. What song was it for? Yes, Gary and Steve.
My Guy.
My Guy's Man at Me is right. 2 points. This year, a television hippie had Hole in His Shoe. Who had the original hit? John's light was up
Traffic.
First. Traffic is the answer. Yes, 2 points. Which film star was waiting for Bananarama this year? John.
Robert De Niro.
Robert De Niro, 2 points. The film Footloose promoted three hits this year. Can you name one of them? Yes, Nick and Simon.
Footloose.
Yes, or Let's Hear It for the Boy Who Dancing. Cheats. 2 points there. Which Apollo moonshot did Adam Ant celebrate in 1984? Nick and Simon first.
Apollo 9.
Apollo 9 is the answer. From which album did Tina Turner have the single hits? What's Love Got to Do with It? Gary and Steve.
Private Dancer.
Yes, Private Dancer. 2 points. And the final question, name the two groups whose lead members were most responsible for Feed the World. Yes, John.
Boomtown Rats.
Ultravox. 1 point. Give you 1 point. Yes, Ultravox together. 1 point there. And that's it. Spandau Ballet 40, Duran Duran 52. We say thank you very much and good night to the losers, at least numerically, if not in spirit. And they are Spandau Ballet, Gary Kemp, Martin Kemp, Steve Norman, John Keeble, and Tony Hadley. And tonight's winners, Duran Duran, Nick Rose, Roger Taylor, Simon Le Bon, Andy Taylor, and John Taylor. We asked Spandau and Duran which video they'd most like to see at the end of the show, and they both said, we'd love to see Cilla Black and Mark Bolan together singing Life is a Gas. We'll see you soon. Bye bye.
Can I sing that one of yours, Life's a Gas? Please. Thank you.
I could have loved you, girl, like a planet. I could have chained your heart to a star. But it really doesn't